Hi everyone, in this video we are going to build a web app with Python that automatically summarizes different podcast episodes. The final app is built with Streamlit and looks like this. We can click on these items and expand them, and then we see a thumbnail together with a title, and then we get a list of all the automatically generated chapters together with a start time and a summary for each chapter. And then on the sidebar we can type in a new episode ID and then start downloading and summarizing a new episode. In order to build this, we are going to use two different APIs for this. We use the Listen Notes API to download the podcast information, and then we use the Assembly AI API to transcribe the podcast and also generate these auto chapters for us. This auto chapters feature is a pretty new feature in the Assembly AI API, and I think this is pretty cool and can be used for many different projects. You can sign up to both APIs for free, and I will leave you the links in the description below. And now let's get started. All right, so I already created a file podcasts.py and another file secrets.py where I store my API keys. And now let's start by setting up the Listen Notes API. So we can go to listennotes.com. And then, of course, you should create an account to get an API key. And you can do this for free. And now let's search for an episode we want to download. So in my case, I search for the Indie Hackers podcast. And then here we should find all the latest episodes. So let's click on the very latest one. And then if we scroll down here on the bottom right, we find this small hint, use API to fetch this episode. So if we click this, then we get to the API documentation. And this is pretty great. So here we find code snippets for all the different API methods. So in our case, we can select the language and change this to Python. And then we have two options. We could use the official podcasts API if we install this, or we could simply use the well-known requests module. So in my case, I want to go with this one. So let's copy and paste this code snippet to our project. And then the only thing we have to change is this API key. So in my case, I can say from secrets import API key listen notes and API key assembly AI. And then here, this is the API key listen notes. So these are two strings I stored in the secrets.py file. And yeah, this is basically all we need. So now I want to do one more thing. I want to say import pretty print, and then I say pretty print dot pretty print to make the output a little bit nicer. And now if we run this, this should already work. So yeah, here we get the JSON response. So let's have a look at this. So the first key is the audio URL, and this is a URL to the MP3 file. So if we click on this, then we could actually download the episode. And this is the main thing that we want to use from this JSON response. And then we also find some other helpful information. For example, we could get the description, or we could get the title, or even a thumbnail. So we can use this to make our app look nicer. And then we could also automatically get the transcript if we sign up for the pro plan, but we don't need this. So yeah, this actually already works. So like I said, we don't need the transcript. So we could also just get rid of this last part here. And then I want to refactor this before we move on. So let's create a function, and let's define a function and call this get episode audio URL, and this should get a episode ID. And then in here we basically want to do exactly this. So let's copy and paste this in here and actually remove this. And then let's also rename this URL. So I want to call this listen notes, and then let's call this episode endpoint. And here I actually want to get rid of this last part. So let me copy this and remove this. And then down here, let's create a if name underscore name equals equals underscore main. And then here we want to call our new function to test this. So let's call get episode URL, and here I want to paste in this episode ID again to test this. And then in our function, we need to set this up now. So we say URL equals the listen notes endpoint API plus a slash and then plus the episode ID. So this should be the same as before. And then let's also rename the headers. So this is the headers for the listen notes API, because we need another one for the assembly AI. So now if you run this again, this should be the same as before. So yeah, this is still working. And now let's extract some different keys that we want to return from this function. So the first thing I want to say is the episode title equals, and we get this by accessing the response.json. So let's actually store this. So let's say data equals response.json. And then here we can print the data, and here we can say data. And this is the key with the name, with the key title. And then let's grab this and copy this, and let's do four or three other tags. So I also want to extract the, let's call this thumbnail, and this has the key thumbnail. Then I also want to get the podcast title. So let's say podcast title equals, and this is actually in the key podcast. And then we have another inner array and here, or inner dictionary, and here we access the title. And then for the last thing, I need, of course, the audio URL. So audio, or we can simply say audio equals data audio. And then we return all four variables. So I want to return audio first, then let's return the thumbnail, then let's return the podcast title, and then the episode title. And then here we can copy this and put it here and extract this immediately when we return this. So we say this is what we get, and then let's print this. So let's print the audio, the thumbnail, the podcast title, and the episode title. And let's remove this pretty print statement, and then let's run this and see if this works. And yeah, so here we get the, I think the first one was the audio URL, then we get the thumbnail URL, and here we get the episode title, and then, or this is, yeah, this is the podcast title and this is the episode title. All right, so now we're already done with setting up the listen notes API. So now we need to work with the assembly AI API. And for this, I already have a tutorial where I showed you step by step how to get a transcript and also the automatic chapters. So I'm not going to explain this all in detail again, but I will leave you a link to the other video. And we also have the code to this video on our GitHub page. So you can go to Assembly AI on GitHub, and then you find this YouTube tutorials repository. And here I created this auto chapters folder. And in here, this is the code where we work with the Assembly AI API. And here we upload a file, then we transcribe it, and then we get the response. So we don't even need to upload a file here because we already have the audio URL that is uploaded somewhere in the web. So we can skip this. So we basically only need these two functions. So let's copy and paste this to our project. So down here. Copy and paste. And then of course we also need the headers and the endpoints. So let's have a look at our repository. So here at the top, we let's grab this and copy and paste this. So let's put it up here. And in this case, we don't need the upload endpoint, but we need the transcript endpoint and our key. So this is the API key assembly AI. Then here again, API key assembly AI, and we also don't need this, so we just need these headers. And let's call this headers and then underscore assembly AI. And yeah, so now we have our transcript endpoint, so this is fine. And then down here, so here we want to say headers assembly AI, and also here headers assembly AI. So in our transcribe function, we set up the transcript request to this audio URL. Then we also want to include auto chapters, so we should use this parameter with true. Then we send a post request and get the JSON response back where we print this, and then we return the ID. And so now down here, we can actually comment the print statement out again. And now we want to get or call this first function and test this. So here we get a transcribe ID back. So here we say transcribe ID equals transcribe. And then we want the audio, and we also want to say auto chapters equals true. So this will start transcribing, and then we can poll the transcription. So in this function, we need the polling endpoint. So this is the transcript endpoint with the transcript ID. And then we send a GET request, and this again returns a JSON. So we can check if the status is completed. And then I save two files in this case. So one is for the transcription and the other one is for the auto chapters. So this is what we need in our tutorial. So for this, we also have to import JSON. So up here we say import JSON. And then this is basically all that we need. So now after our transcribe ID, we can say result equals, and then we want to poll the transcript ID. And yeah, this is all that we need to get the automatic chapters. And I want to make a few slight changes. So in the chapters JSON file, I want to store a couple more information about our podcast. So here, I already have the chapters, and right now I only dump this to the JSON file, but now let's do some more information here. So let's create a dictionary data equals, and this gets the key chapters, and then we put in the chapters as the first value. And then let's put in some optional keyword arguments. So with double asterisks, and then here let's iterate over them. So we say for key and value in quarks.items. And then we say our data gets the key as key, and we store the value also inside this dictionary. And then we say JSON dump the data. And now down here, we can pass all these variables to this function as optional keyword arguments. So we say audio equals audio, thumbnail equals thumbnail, podcast title equals podcast title, and episode title equals episode title. And then this should return a result. So if we save the transcript, then we want to return true, and otherwise we return false at the end. So this means the status is not yet completed. So yeah, then let's create one more function, and we call this pipeline. So here we put everything together, and this also gets the episode ID. And in here, we basically want to do exactly this. So let's copy and paste this to our pipeline. And then down here, we only want to call the pipeline with this episode ID. So we copy and paste this in here. And here we use the episode ID. And here what we want to do is we want to repeatedly pull the status. So we say while true, and then we pull this, and then we get the result back, and then we check if result or if result. Yeah, if this is true, then we can break. And otherwise, we want to wait a couple of seconds. So we can say print, and then let's say waiting for 60 seconds. And then here we say time.sleep for sleep for 60 seconds. And of course, we also have to import this. So we say import time. And yeah, this is all that we need. So now we can run the pipeline, and then this should put everything together. So let's run this and see if this works. So yeah, here it already printed the last JSON response from the Assembly AI API, and then it says waiting for 60 seconds. So this is a long episode, so this is over 1 hour, so this could take a few minutes. So let's wait for this to finish. All right, this worked. So in this case, it took about 8 minutes, and then we see the new files in our folder. So here we have the text file with the transcript, and then, so this is just formatted into one line, and then we have this chapters JSON, and here we should get the auto summaries for all the chapters. And then if we scroll down here, we should also find the additional information that we stored. So we have the audio URL, the thumbnail, the podcast title, and the episode title. So yeah, great. This is basically everything we need, and now let's put everything together and build a quick web app with this. So for this, let's create a new file, and let's call this app.py. And for this, we use Streamlit. So I say import Streamlit as st. Of course, you have to install this with pip install Streamlit. Then let's also import glob. So you will see for what I use this in a second. And then we also need JSON in here. And then we say from podcasts import the pipeline. So now this is the only function we need that puts everything together. And now let's create a title for our app, and let's call this podcast summaries. And now let's test our web app. So in the terminal, you should say streamlit run and then the file name. So this is app.py, and this should start the web app and open in the browser. So I'm getting a error here in the secrets py file. And so it looks like this is the official core module. So I actually should rename this secrets.py file. So let's go to refactor, rename, and then let's call this API underscore secrets, and then I can click on refactor, and PyCharms should be smart enough now to also rename this here. So yeah, this worked. So let's go back to our browser again and refresh the site. And now it's working. So yeah, this was our error. So now we have a web app that is up and running. So let's start implementing this. And before we do this, I want to copy and paste two more chapters.json files. So I already did this before, and now I copied this to my clipboard, and I can paste this to this project. So now we should see three different files already. And now let's start by loading these files. So we want to find all JSON files, and we can do this with the glob module. So we say glob.glob, and then we want to search for basically all files. So we say a star with the ending JSON, and this will give us a list of, in if it works correctly, of these three files. And then we want to iterate over this. So we say for file in JSON files, then we can load this. So we say with open the file, and we want to open this in read mode as F, And then we want to load all the information. So we say data equals json.load from our file. And now we want to extract the information. So we say chapters equals data with the key chapters. And then we also want to put in or extract all the other information that we've put in. So here, down here, we want the audio, the thumbnail, the podcast, and the episode title. So let's go to our podcast.py, and then let's grab these three or these four information and paste this here. So the episode title has the key episode title, thumbnail is thumbnail, podcast should be podcast title, and the audio is audio underscore URL, if I remember correctly. Audio URL, thumbnail, podcast title, episode title, and the chapters key, of course. So yeah, this should work. And now I want to create a expander widget in Streamlit. So I can do this very easily by saying with streamlit.expander, and this gets a title. So here we want to put in the, let's put the podcast title first, then a dash, and then the episode title. And then in here, first, let's display the image. So we say streamlit.image. And then here we can simply use the thumbnail URL. And then let's also specify a width. And in this case, we say 200. And then let's write the episode title again in Markdown a little bit nicer. So we can use Markdown format. And this again uses a F string. And then let's make this a H4 tag by using three hashtags. And then here we use the episode title again. And then for the first example, let's simply write the whole chapter's information. So this should be a list. And then let's go back to our site and reload the site. And we have a syntax error. So if we look back, then here I'm missing a colon, of course. So now let's try it again. And again, a error, key error, audio URL. And yeah, so this is because in the files that I copied, I think I named this audio. So let's make this consistent. So every audio key should be audio URL. So this is fine already. And this is now everything is fine. So yeah, let's try this again one more time. And now if we load this, yeah, now we see this. We have three expander widgets and we could click on this. And then we see the thumbnail, the title again of the episode title. And now here we get all the summaries that we get from the Assembly AI API. So we get a summary. Then we get a headline. So this is basically another summary of this summary, which is even shorter. And then we see start and end time in milliseconds. So yeah, this already works. Now there's only one more thing. I want to make this output a little bit nicer. So let's go back to our app. And then I created a little helper function. So I will simply copy and paste this for you. So this gets the chapters and then converts the time to seconds, minutes, and hours and puts it in a nice format. And then we only put the summary in here. And then here we can say streamlit.write and then we call this function get clean summary of this chapter. And then let's have a look at the site again. So now if we reload it, it looks like this. So this is already looking nicer. And yeah, so now let's add one more thing. So let's create a sidebar where we can download another episode. And this is also pretty easy with Streamlit. So we can say episode ID, and this is a streamlit.txt input, and then let's call this episode ID, and we can simply move this to the sidebar by saying streamlet.sidebar.thewidget. Then we also want to create a button equals and then streamlet.sidebar.button, and we give it the label episode download episode summary, and then we check if the button is true. So if this was clicked, then this is true, and if we have a valid episode ID, so if this string has at least one character, then we say streamlet.sidebar.write, and then we say get as a string get auto chapters dot dot dot, and then we simply want to call this pipeline. And now if we execute it like this, so if we say pipeline with the episode ID, then this would work, but this can take a few minutes and this would block the whole application. So I want to make one small improvement here and run this in a background process or in another background thread. So there are several different ways how to do this, and one simple way is to say from threading import the thread, and then we create one thread here. So we say t equals thread, and then this gets the target, which is the function name without the parentheses, and this also gets an argument, so args equals, and this should be a tuple. So here we put the episode ID with a comma, and then we can comment this out, and then we simply say t.start, and now this is all we need. So now let's rerun our app and see if we have the sidebar. And now let's go to the Listen Notes API again and search for another podcast episode. So I want to use the Stack Overflow podcast here. So let's grab this one, and then again we can go to the API notes, because here we find the ID. So this is the episode ID, and then we put it in our app and click the download, and then this should work. So let's run this. So yeah, it prints, it gets the auto chapters, and our app is not blocking. So now it will take a few moments. So right now this is not ideal, because we have to refresh the page ourselves and check if the episode was downloaded. But yeah, this is an improvement you can do yourself. All right, so I've waited a couple of moments and downloading should be done. So let's refresh the page. And then again, we get a key error. So again, let's have a look at this audio, at this JSON file. So again, this should be audio URL. So here we want to use audio URL, and this means that in the podcast's PI file, we want to use the key audio URL. So this will now be our key in the JSON file. So now the next time we run this, this should work. But yeah, basically now our app is working. So let's rerun it again. And now we have this new episode as well here with the auto chapters. And yeah, this is pretty cool. So if you couldn't follow everything, then again, you will find the code on GitHub, and I will put the link in the description. All right, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and let me know in the comments which podcasts you want to summarize with this app. And also don't forget to grab your free Assembly AI token using the link in the description below. And then I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.